children. Hope you all are safe and fine. Today we are going to start with economics unit 1 for the first year academic session. Previous class we had studied about these topics which were included in our class 8, 9 and 10. I have already told you all to go through the basic concepts which have been related to our economics, and you must have read all the topics what is given in the textbooks of school time. I have already given you all the introduction of what economics is and how it is useful and what are the importance of economics in our economy. Now here we are going to start with the economics. Next, coming to the syllabus, in the first year we are going to learn 10 units, in which first unit is introduction to economics. And second, theory of consumer behavior. Third, demand analysis. Fourth is prediction analysis. Fifth, market analysis. Sixth, theories of distribution. Seventh, national income analysis. Eighth, macroeconomic analysis. Ninth, money, banking and inflation. And 10 is basic statistics for economics. All these topics we are going to learn in detail in each and every unit in our first year. Now coming to the introduction to economics. Now in this we are going to learn 5 subheadings. Like first is introduction. Second, definition of economics. The definitions of economics given by different economists and how it has been criticized and what is the real definition of economics. Then fundamental problems of an economy. When we are producing the goods, consuming it or distributing it, what are the problems we are going to face in our economy? As how to produce the good, what to produce and what quantities have to be produced are discussed under fundamental problems of an economy. Then micro and macroeconomics. We have dealing with two types of economies, that is microeconomics and macroeconomics. Micro which deals with the smaller units, whereas macro deals with the whole unit. Next, basic concepts of economics. Now what are the basic concepts are like goods, wealth, then wants, utility, and all these we are going to learn in the basic concepts of economics. Nature and scope of economics. That means what is the nature of economics and scope of the economics. Next, coming to economics, we have already discussed in our previous class on what economics is. Economics is a study of human behavior. I have already explained to you in the last class. Then economics is a study of relationship between satisfying unlimited wants and limited resources which have alternative uses. We know that our wants are unlimited and resources to satisfy these unlimited wants are limited. So we have to take alternative uses of these resources. Next is economic deals with how an individual as well as society allocate their scarce resources to satisfy their needs according to the importance with the main objective of optimal utilization. So whatever goods are being available in our economy are scarce. That means scarce is less. We have less resources. So how we are going to adjust our wants with these scarce resources, seeing that the full utilization of the resources have to be done. Next, and now coming to economic activities. Now what is economic activity? Economic activity relates with money. Now today money plays a significant role in our economic activity. Without money we cannot purchase or produce or do any activity. Money plays an important role in our economic life. Economic activities are those which are performed to earn money. Whatever activities we are taking in order to earn money, when a person is working, when he is expecting money in return, that means it's called as an economic activity. That means when a person is selling any commodity, he is selling in order to satisfy our wants and in turn earning money. Without money, he cannot survive. So main intention of the person is to sell commodities is to earn money. Producers produce goods, distributors distribute, many people consume goods in order to satisfy their wants. So how are they consuming? How are they getting all these resources? By the help of money. They are earning all these with the help of money. The economic types of activities here we go with production, consumption, distribution, investment, exchange. That means in economic activity, we have different types of economic activities. Now, what are the economic activities as we have discussed? Production, consumption, distribution, investment and exchange. Let us study what all these activities are referred to in detail. Now, coming to production. What is production? Production is the process of creation of utility or the creation of want satisfying goods and services. So, any commodity which satisfies human wants are produced in order to satisfy the unlimited wants with the help of resources. So, whatever we are producing with the help of the scarce resources is called as production. In order, we are producing goods as well as services. Now, coming to the point, production. Production is classified into two. That is, we are producing goods and producing the services. Now, what are goods? Converting raw materials into finished goods. That means whatever raw materials are available, we are producing it into finished goods, which is ready for consumption. Now, what is a service? Converting knowledge, idea into services. So, whatever knowledge, whatever ideas we have, we are putting it into use so that the people are getting the services from the people. Now, let us see the examples for production of goods and services. Now, examples are, see, farm production. How people are producing the goods on the use of land and labor. This is called as natural production. Next is, we have food production. So, how we are producing food with the help of machines. Here also we need labor. We have capital, we have raw materials and all, so that we can produce the raw materials into finished goods. The food is ready to consume. Next is, we have textile production. So, what is textile production? Converting of fiber into textiles or converting yarn into textiles so that the cloth will be used to consume. When we are using all these commodities, these are converted from raw materials into finished goods. So, these are the examples of goods. Now, coming to services, now we have services of police, services of teacher, what teacher is imparting knowledge and ideas to the students. Then next we have doctor as a service. Doctor is treating the patient with his ideas and is this knowledge what he has. Then next we have a lawyer. That means lawyer with her ideas, she will try to solve the cases of her clients. So in this way, police, teacher, doctor and lawyer are the services which are people we are which who are rendering services to the society, to the economy. They are working in order to earn money. Police is earning money, teacher is earning money, doctor is earning money, lawyer also is earning money. So what all these people are engaged in the services, they are rendering services in order to earn money. So all these come under economic activities. Now let's come to consumption. Now what is consumption? Consumption is a process of using goods and services for the satisfaction of human wants. So when we are purchasing goods and services for our self-consumption, for our utility or in order to satisfy our own wants, then it is called as consumption. So we are not purchasing the goods in order to resell it. We are using the goods, purchasing the goods in order to consume it. That is final consumption good is called as consumption, which are helpful for the satisfaction of human wants. Next, these are the final consumption goods which are being with the food products, dairy products, which are directly consumed by the people in order to satisfy their wants. Suppose if you want to eat an ice cream, we will consume an ice cream directly. We want to drink milk or any cheese or anything. All these goods are helpful to consume and which are satisfying the human want. Next, we want to travel. We have a car. Car is a direct consumption good. We are purchasing car in order to use it for our self. That means we are using for our convenience where we have to, when we need to travel from one place to another, we have a personal car. Then next we are having fruits or anything. These are natural foods, girls. Fruits are natural. They are given by nature. So these foods are directly consumed by the people. That means we purchase fruits from the market in order to consume it. Then next comes distribution. Now what is distribution? The word distribution itself tells us that distribution is distributing the commodities or anything. Now here, distribution of income among individuals and among the factors of production. When all the people working together, when all are working together, whatever income we earn, it has to be distributed equally among all the people based on the amount of work they have done. So based on whatever amount of knowledge or whatever skill, whatever they have worked hard, based on that, we need to distribute the income. In an organization, we see different people working in different stages. So each stage, a person's work will be different. I already discussed you all about the laborer skill. There are three types of laborers. So based on the skill of a laborer, they have given their income. So this income, whatever we are earning, is to be distributed among the four factors of production. Now, what are the four factors of production? Land, labor, capital and enterprise. Land is a free gift of nature. Labor is a skill of a person. Capital is machinery or any investment. And enterprise is an organization where you get the name for your commodity. Next, now these four factors, we have four factors of production here. First is land. Second is labor. Third is capital and fourth is the organization. So when these four factors together are earning an income, so the total income or wealth or output, whatever has been produced, whatever has been invested, whatever have been produced, all these when we put together, now it has to be distributed among the four factors of production in the form of rent. Land will earn a remuneration of rent. Labor will earn a remuneration of wages. Capital will earn a remuneration of interest, and organization will earn profit. So these four factors are earning income in the form of rent, wages, interest and profit. So this total income has to be distributed between the four factors of the production. Now coming to exchange. What is exchange? Exchanging of goods with the help of money. We are giving money and we are consuming the goods. When we go to a market, we give money and then we purchase commodities or raw materials. A producer will purchase raw materials by giving them money. All the transactions are carried on only with the help of money. So here exchange is taken place in two parts. What is it? It ensures the transfer of goods and services. So what is exchange? It ensures that the transfer of goods and services and receiving of something against giving something. We are giving money and we are receiving goods. So here we have a picture of goods, exchanging of goods and services. Next, exchange can be classified into two: monetary system and barter system. What is monetary system? Exchange with the help of money. Whatever goods we are exchanging with the help of money is called as monetary system. And prior to monetary system, we had barter system where goods were exchanged for goods. Because of the many difficulties faced by the consumers or the producers, this system was not into vogue. So that's why monetary system has come into existence. Now coming to the next topic, investment. Now what is investment? An investment is a purchase of goods that are not consumed today but are used in the future to create wealth. So whatever we are saving amount, every organization or every company or every producer will try to save some amount. Why they are saving the amount? In order to invest it for the future purpose. So they are purchasing goods to create wealth. They are purchasing building, they are purchasing machinery, they are purchasing land. So in order to be used in the future today. So this whatever savings we are investing is called as investment, which is used for the future purpose. Now this investment will be on commodities, cryptocurrency, real estates or stocks or bonds and any other option. Whatever money is being saved and investment is done, that is called as investment. Next we come to non-economic activities. Now what is non-economic activity? These are the activities which are not related to the money. So here people are working but they are not expecting money in return. So whatever money they are, whatever services they are rendering or whatever goods they are producing, they are only trying to help the people but they are not earning money. Their main intention is not to earn profits or not to earn money. So all these activities which are related to money is called as non-economic activities. activity. It satisfies one's emotional and social need. When a person is in need, when a person is not satisfied, then we try to help them. That help what we are giving them is not called as non-economic activity. Now these activities are done for love, sympathy, etc. So out of love we may do, or out of sympathy we may do. Your friend is in need, you are helping her, but you are not expecting anything in return. That is called as love for a friend. Then you are helping her. Mother will give food and everything to the children. That is out of love mother is giving you. That means she is not expecting anything in return. So these activities are called as non-economic activities where we are not earning any income. Now what are the examples? Mother teaching a child. Mother is teaching her child. She is not expecting anything in return. She is not expecting money. She is not earning any income. Next is a mother cooking and children and other father is helping the mother. That means when we are helping our parents or when we are helping our brothers and sisters, it is called as a non-economic activity. And non-economic activity, the best example is Mother Teresa, where she has helped the society but she has not earned even a single rupee. She has only rendered services to the poor people. Next we come to resources. Now what are resources? Materials, objects, people and tools used to make goods and services we purchase are known as resources. So whatever we are using, whatever objects or whatever materials, raw materials, tools, labor, people, all what we are using in order to produce goods and services is called as resources. We are purchasing these goods. So these are called as resources. Now this is a resource. From log we are making it into table. Not only table, we can make it furniture, we can make cupboards, or we can do any other thing with the help of log. Then again, gold is also a natural resource. With the help of gold, we can make gold ornaments or any other thing with the help of gold. The next is petroleum. Petroleum is also a natural resource which is used to in the vehicles to travel. Now we have different types of resources. What are the types of resources? Natural resources, human resources and capital resources. We will learn only these three types of resources in detail. Now we have three types. What are they? Natural, human and capital. Raw materials supplied by nature are called as natural resources. People who produce goods and services are called as human resources. Money, products and supplies used in the production of goods and services is called as capital resource. So here we can see three types, that is nature, human and capital. Now not in natural resources, things found in nature and are not man-made that are used to make things are called as natural resources. That means whatever we get from nature, trees or oil or any minerals or sunshine, all these are the natural resources. So these natural resources are either renewable or non-renewable. What are renewable resources? Things that replenish or remake themselves. Once you cut a tree, again a tree comes. Once the sunshine is gone, again next day we get again a sunshine. That means we can save the sunshine in the form of solar energy. Whereas fuel and other commodities are vanished. That means they are operated. So they are called as non-renewable resources. Once they are used, cannot be used again. So here we can see the examples of natural resources. We have sun, forest, rock, minerals, animals, air, oil, water and soil. So all these are the natural resources which we get from nature. Man cannot create all these. So these are all not man-made. They are natural resources. Now what is a human resource? Human resource is a set of people who make up the workforce of organization, business, sector and industry. It is a knowledge which the individuals embody. Example, labor who do their work. So in an organization, we can see all the people together. One work cannot be done by a single person. When we all come together, when all the people with different knowledge, different ideas, with different skills, when we come together, then we can achieve our goal. So here also all the people, when they come together in an organization or in a business sector or in an industry, when they come together with their own knowledge, with their own skill, then it is called as the human resource. Here you can see different people working for helping each other. Now capital resource. Now what is a capital resource? Capital resources are goods produced and used to make other goods and services. So whatever goods and services we are producing with the help of other resources, that is the sense we are using machinery, we are using land, we are using buildings, we are using tools. Now for agricultural purpose we are using land. On the land to dig the soil or plow the land we need machines, tractor and all these. When we are using big machines or any other tools or equipments, those are called as capital resources. Now here capital resources are what? They are man-made inputs used to produce consumer goods. So capital goods, machinery, building and tools are used to produce other goods like crane, for plant or hammer or anything. These tools are all man-made tools. They are produced by man with the help of using these scarce resources which have alternative uses. Thank you children. We'll see in the next class again.